गुड मॉर्निंग गर्ल्स। सो अगेन वेलकम बैक टू अ न्यू लेक्चर। नाउ टुडे इज माय सेवेंथ लेक्चर। नाउ कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ द सेम टॉपिक, एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। सो लास्ट टाइम आई टोल्ड यू सम वेरी गुड एप्लीकेशंस ऑन इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड। नाउ टुडे ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस some excellent applications we got now based on electric field concept. Now let us come to the third application. Already I told you now two applications. Now this will be now application number three. Now let us see now what the application will be saying. Now let us say, now you got an oil drop of mass m and it is given a charge q. And what we are doing, now we are applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. Now remember what the application will be saying. Now consider a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. Now what we are doing? Now we are taking an oil drop of mass m and charge q, and the oil drop will be placed now inside the electric field. So now it has been found, now the oil drop will be remaining under equilibrium, or the oil drop will be remaining under equilibrium now within the electric field. So remember the concept, now when we are keeping the oil drop that will be carrying a positive charge q in the vertical electric field, so it has been found now the oil drop will be remaining at rest, or the oil drop will be remaining under equilibrium. Now what do you mean by it will be remaining under equilibrium? Now meaning now the oil drop is neither going up nor it will be going down, or rather the oil drop will remain suspended in the vertical electric field. That's the reason why now we say now the oil drop will be remaining under equilibrium. So now, did you know now what are the external forces that will be acting on the oil drop, or what are the external forces which are acting on the oil drop that will be keeping the oil drop now under the equilibrium? Now everybody knows now one external force will be now the weight of the oil drop will be acting vertically downward. So one external force that will be acting on the oil drop will be mg, that will be acting vertically downward, and the other force will be the electrostatic force qe that will be acting in the upward direction. Now you remember, now already I told a positive charge will be experiencing an electrostatic force now along the direction of the electric field, or the positive charge will be experiencing the electrostatic force now along the direction of the applied electric field. That's the reason why now the electrostatic force QE will be acting in the vertically upward direction. So now it is very clear from the diagram, or it is very clear from the free body diagram, there are two forces that will be acting on the oil drop. Now one will be the weight will be acting vertically downward, and the electrostatic force QE will be acting now vertically upward. So now, what will happen now under equilibrium? Now let us say, now what will happen now under equilibrium? Now remember, now what will be happening now under equilibrium? So you already know, now under equilibrium, now the upward force will be balancing that downward force, or under equilibrium, the upward force will always be equal to that downward force. So therefore, now I can write for the equilibrium, now I can write, now mg will be numerically equal to qe. Now this can be further written. Now let us say, now this will be, now equation number 1, now this can be further written. Now you already know, now the mass of the oil drop will be numerically equal to now volume into density. Now remember, now one important thing, now the oil drop will be acting like a solid sphere, or the oil drop will be acting like a solid sphere. That is the reason why now the mass of the oil drop can be written as a product of volume and density. So therefore, the mass of the oil drop will be numerically equal to, now what will be the volume of a sphere, or what will be the volume of a solid sphere. Now remember the important point, now the oil drop will be acting like a solid sphere, or the oil drop will be acting like a solid sphere. And you already know, now the volume of the solid sphere will be given by the formula, now 4 by 3 into pi r cube, now multiplied by rho. So remember, the volume of the solid sphere, or the volume of the oil droplet, can be written 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho. Now let us solve. Now this will be, now equation 2. Now what I will do, I will substitute the value of mass m in the above equation, or wherever I got the mass of the oil drop, so the mass can be written now 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho. So therefore, now what I get, now 4 by 3 pi r cube into rho, now multiplied by gravity, will be numerically equal to qe. Now remember, now what I can do, now from this equation, I can find out, now what will be the radius of the oil drop, or from this equation I can determine now what will be the radius of the given oil drop. So now let us see now how to find out the radius of the given oil drop.
So if I remove the diagram, so now I can find out now what will be the radius of the oil drop. So this can be further written now 4 pi r cube now multiplied by rho g will be numerically equal to now p will be cross multiplied. So if you cross multiply 3, so what I get, so I will be getting now 4 pi r cube into rho g will be numerically equal to now 3 q e. So therefore, so I can find now what will be the radius of the oil drop. So r cube will be numerically equal to now what are the terms which are there here will be going to the denominator. So what I get now 3QE now divided by I get now 4 pi now multiplied by rho g. So therefore now r cube can be written by the formula now 3QE now divided by 4 pi into rho g. So therefore the radius of the oil drop will be numerically equal to now 3QE now whole divided by now 4 pi into rho g now whole power 1 by 3. So therefore now remember the formula we get. So the radius of the oil drop will be numerically equal to now 3QE now divided by 4 pi rho g now whole power 1 by 3. So remember now that will be the radius of the oil drop we can determine from the equilibrium condition or from the equilibrium of the oil drop I can determine now what will be the radius of the oil drop that will be given by now 3QE now divided by 4 pi rho g now whole power 1 by 3. So now remember now that will be the radius of the oil drop. So now if you have taken this obligation, so now in the same obligation now I got now one more bit. Now let us say now this will be the first bit. Now this will be the first bit. Now the second bit we got that is also a very important bit. Now the second bit we got, now that will be now another important bit we got. So now what I will do, so now I will be reversing the direction of the electric field. Now remember in the second bit, now what I am doing, now keeping the oil drop undisturbed or keeping the oil drop undisturbed. Now what I am doing, I am reversing the direction of the electric field. So meaning what? So now I am applying the electric field in the vertically downward direction, or now I am going to apply the electric field in the vertically downward direction, and now let us see now what will happen if I reverse the direction of the electric field now without disturbing the oil droplet. Now let us see now what is going to happen. Now once again we got the oil drop. Now what I am doing? So now I am reversing the direction of the electric field, or now the oil drop will be act. So now the electric field will be acting in the vertically or downward direction. So now can anybody now tell me now what will happen to the oil drop, or what will happen to the oil drop? Now whether the oil drop will be remaining under equilibrium, or the oil drop will be accelerating not down the electric field. So now we need to find now the moment I'm reversing the electric field, or the moment I'm reversing the electric field. Now what will happen to the oil drop? Now whether the charged oil drop will be still remaining under equilibrium, or the oil drop will be accelerating not down, or the oil drop will be accelerating not down in the downward direction. Now let us see now what is going to happen. So now what are the external forces that will be acting on the oil drop? Now no doubt now wind will be acting vertically or downward, or mg will be acting now vertically downward. Now apart from that, now what is the other force? Now the other force will be the electrostatic force QE, and that will also be acting in the downward direction. Now remember, now no doubt the weight will always be acting in the downward direction. Now apart from that, the electrostatic force will also be acting in the downward direction. So why? Because now always now remember the point, a positive charge will always be experiencing the electrostatic force now along the direction of the electric field, or any positive charge will always be experiencing the electrostatic force now along the direction of the electric field. That's the reason why the same positive charge will be experiencing the electrostatic force in the downward direction. So now, by looking at the free body diagram, now can you tell me now what will be the net force that will be acting on the oil drop, or what will be the net force that will be acting on the oil drop? You can clearly see now both the forces will be acting in the downward direction. So the net force that will be acting on the oil drop will be QE plus mg, or the net force that will be acting on the oil drop will be numerically equal to now mg plus QE. So that is called now equation number 1. But you remember now what was the equilibrium condition? Now you remember from equilibrium condition, Now you remember it. Now what was the equilibrium condition? Now you remember it. From the equilibrium condition, now we already got, now mg will be numerically equal to qe. Now you already remember it. From the first case or from the equilibrium condition, when the electric field will be acting vertically upward. Now you already know from the equilibrium condition, now mg will be numerically equal to qe. So what I will do, now wherever I got qe, so qe can be replaced by mg, or wherever I got the electrostatic force, so qe, not bad, can be replaced by mg. Now let us see, now what we are going to get further. So therefore, so I can write the net force that will be acting on the oil drop will be numerically equal to mg. Now qe will also be equal to mg. So we get, now F net will be numerically equal to, now mg plus mg, or I can write the net force that will be acting on the oil drop will be numerically equal to 2mg. But you remember from the Newton's second law, or you remember from the Newton's second law, now F net will be numerically equal to ma. So ma will be numerically equal to 2mg. So mass and mass will be getting cancelled. So the acceleration of the oil drop in the vertically downward direction will be numerically equal to 2g. Or remember, now what is the meaning we got? So meaning what? Now whenever you are reversing the electric field, or whenever the electric field will be reversed, then remember, now the oil drop will never be remaining under equilibrium, or the oil drop will never be remaining under equilibrium, but rather the oil drop will be accelerating in the downward direction, or the oil drop will be accelerating in the downward direction with an acceleration that will be numerically equal to 2g. So remember, now that will be the acceleration of the oil drop, or that will be the acceleration of the oil drop in the vertically or downward direction. So remember, now that will be now application number 2, or that will be, now we got the application number 3. So that will be the third application we got for the electric field. So now let us see now one more application. So now, if you take this one, so now let's see, now one more application, now based on the uniform electric field. So now let's see, now what is the application we got, or what will be the force application revolves on the uniform electric field. So now remember now the four application of the God or the four application of the God. Now listen very carefully. Now once again, now what I am doing, I am applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. Now let us say, now consider an electric field that will be acting vertically upward direction, whose magnitude will be equal to capital E. So initially, now what I am doing, now consider a uniform electric field that will be acting in the vertically upward direction, and let us say the magnitude of the electric field will be capital E. So now let us say we got a charged particle Q that will be moving with a constant velocity V naught. So consider a charged particle Q that will be traveling along the horizontal with a uniform velocity of V naught. So now what is happening? So now the charged particle will be entering now perpendicular to the electric field, or now the charged particle will be entering the electric field now perpendicular to it. So now we need to find now what will be the path that will be followed by the particle, or what will be the path that will be followed by the particle now whenever the particle now moving with a constant velocity V naught along the horizontal will be entering now perpendicular to the electric field. So once again, now remember the application. Now what we are doing, now we are applying a vertical electric field of magnitude capital E. Now let us say, now we got a charged particle Q that will be traveling with a constant velocity V naught, and suddenly the charged particle will be entering now perpendicular to the direction of the electric field, or the charged particle will be entering now perpendicular to the direction of the electric field. So now the question will be, now what will be the path that will be followed by the charged particle now inside the electric field, or what will be the path that will be followed by the charged particle now inside the electric field. So meaning, now whether the particle will be following the straight line path, or whether the particle will be describing a circular path, or whether the particle will be describing a parabolic path, or whether it will be describing an elliptical path. So now we need to investigate, or now we need to determine. So whenever the charged particle or will be entering now perpendicular to the direction of the electric field, then what will be the path that will be followed by the particle now inside the electric field? So whether the charged particle will be describing a straight line path, or whether the particle will be undergoing a circular motion, or whether the particle will be describing a parabolic path, or whether it will be exhibiting an elliptical path. Now let us see now how to find out. Now very simple. Now remember, now along the horizontal direction, or remember the along the horizontal direction, there is no electric field, or along the horizontal direction there is no electric field. That's the reason why in the absence of the electric field, now all along the horizontal the particle will be traveling with a constant velocity. So remember, now along the horizontal there is no electric field, and you already know in the absence of the electric field the particle does not experience any force. That's the reason why now along the horizontal the velocity of the particle will be remaining constant, or all along the horizontal the particle will be traveling with a constant velocity. But now what will happen now along the vertical? So if I draw the free body diagram, now what is happening along the vertical, or what is happening now along the y axis? Now you already know along the vertical we are applying the electric field. That's the reason why the charged particle will be experiencing the electrostatic force now along the vertical direction, and whenever the particle will be experiencing the electrostatic force, then you already know then the particle will be accelerating along the vertical. That is the reason why the velocity of the particle will be keep on increasing. So remember this important concept. Now what is happening? Now along the vertical we are applying the electric field. Now that is the reason the charged particle will be experiencing an electrostatic force now along the vertical direction, and due to the electrostatic force now the charged particle will be accelerating now along the vertical. That's the reason why the velocity of the particle will be keep on increasing now along with the time. So now meaning what? So along the vertical direction, now remember the same charged particle will be experiencing the electrostatic force that will be numerically equal to QE.
So that's the reason why now what will be the acceleration along the vertical. So you already know, so along the vertical, now remember, so along the vertical, the electrostatic force that will be experienced by the charged particle will be numerically equal to QE. That's the reason why now force will be numerically equal to now mass into acceleration, now m into ay will be numerically equal to QE. Now meaning, now along the vertical, the acceleration of the charged particle will be numerically equal to now QE or divided by m, or remember, now along the vertical, the particle will be accelerating. That is the reason why the velocity of the particle will be keep on increasing. Now along the vertical direction, now along with the time. So remember, now that will be the acceleration we got along the vertical. So now what I will do, now first let us find out. So if I remove this diagram, so now you already know, now first we'll analyze, now what is going to happen, now along the horizontal, now first we'll consider, now what is going to happen, now along the horizontal. So you already know, now along the horizontal, the velocity of the particle will be remaining constant. Now since there is no electric field along the horizontal, so no force will be experienced by the particle along the horizontal. So acceleration of the particle now along the horizontal will be equal to zero. So remember, now along the horizontal, now you already know, now the particle will be moving with a constant velocity V naught. So now let us find out, now what will be the horizontal displacement that will be covered by the particle along the horizontal, now after a time t second. So first, now what I am doing, now first I am finding out, now what will be the horizontal displacement that will be covered by the particle now after a time t second. Now let us see, now how to obtain, now what will be the horizontal displacement that will be covered by the particle now after a time t second. So what I can write, so along the horizontal, now along the horizontal I can apply the kinematical equation, now ut plus half, so ut plus half at square, or along the horizontal I can write, now sx will be numerically equal to ux into t plus half ax into t square. So remember, in order to determine the horizontal displacement that will be covered by the particle along the horizontal,
am applying the kinematical equation. Now s will be numerically equal to now ut plus half ab square, or I can write now sx will be numerically equal to ux into t plus half ax t square. Now substitute. Now what are the conditions required along the horizontal? So along the horizontal, so what are the conditions required? So along the horizontal, now here, now sx will be numerically equal to x, and you already know the horizontal velocity will be remaining constant, or all along the horizontal the velocity will be remaining constant. So ux will be numerically equal to v naught, and you know now the acceleration along the horizontal will be equal to zero. So you already know now what are the conditions we got along the horizontal. So displacement covered will be numerically equal to x. Now and you already know now all along the horizontal the velocity will be remaining constant, that will be numerically equal to v naught, and you know the acceleration along the horizontal will always be equal to zero. So if I substitute in the above formula, now what I am going to get? So therefore, now x will be numerically equal to now v naught into t plus the second term will become zero. So therefore, the horizontal displacement covered will be numerically equal to now v naught into t. So v naught into t. So if you remember this formula, so the horizontal displacement covered will be numerically equal to now v naught into t. So therefore, now from this equation, so I can find out now what will be the value of t. So therefore, now t will be numerically equal to now what we get, now x divided by v naught, or the time taken will be numerically equal to now x divided by v naught. Now let us call, now that will be our equation number one. Now similarly, now let us concentrate along the vertical, or now let us concentrate now along the vertical. Now you already know along the vertical, now the particle will be experiencing the electrostatic force. That's the reason why the particle will be accelerating along the vertical. So the velocity of the particle will be keep on increasing along the vertical. So now once again, now what I will do, so now I will find out now what will be the vertical displacement that will be covered by the charged particle in the same time t second, or what will be the displacement that will be covered by the particle now along the vertical in the same time t second. So therefore, now again coming back to the vertical direction. So again, now coming back to the vertical direction. So I can write now along the vertical, now same way, Now I can write the kinematical equation Sy will be numerically equal to Uy into t plus half Ay into t square. So now, can you tell me now what are the conditions along the vertical, or what are the conditions required along the vertical? So you already know along the vertical, now Sy will be numerically equal to 5. Now similarly, now what will be the initial velocity now along the vertical? Now remember, now along the vertical, now the initial velocity will be 0. Or remember, now along the vertical direction, now the initial velocity will always be equal to 0. So Uy will be equal to 0. And you already know now what is the acceleration along the vertical. Now already I derived that will be given by now Qe divided by m. So just now I obtained now what will be the acceleration along the vertical, that will be given by now Qe divided by m. Now substitute now all of them in this equation. Now let us see now what we are going to get. So substitute all the conditions in the above equation. So what we get? So y will be numerically equal to, now Uy will become 0. So first term will be 0. Now multiplied by now half into now Qe divided by m, now multiplied by p square. So therefore, if I simplify further, or if I simplify now further, now what you are going to get? So now, if I simplify further, so vertical displacement will be numerically equal to, now what we get? Now Qe now divided by 2m now multiplied by t square, or upon simplification, so the vertical displacement that will be covered by the particle as a function of time will be given by the formula. So y will be numerically equal to now Qe divided by 2m into t square. Now let us call it, now this will be now equation number 2. Now what you do? Now substitute the value of time, or substitute the value of time in equation number 2. So wherever we got the time of travel, the time of travel can be written by x divided by v naught. So let us see now what we are going to get. Now substitute 1 in equation number 2. So therefore, the vertical displacement will be numerically equal to now Qe divided by 2m now multiplied by now t will be given by x divided by v naught whole square. Now further, if you open the bracket, so y will be numerically equal to now Qe divided by 2m now multiplied by x square now divided by v naught square. Now this can be further written, now y will be numerically equal to now Qe now divided by 2m v naught square. So I can write now y will will be numerically equal to now QE now divided by 2m V naught square now multiplied by x square. Now remember, now all these bracket terms are constant. Now you already know, now all the terms in the bracket will be constant. And remember, now x will always be a variable and y will always be a variable. So remember, the position coordinates y will be a variable and the x coordinate will always be a variable, but the bracket term will be remaining constant. So now if you look at the formula, now what I will do, I will replace now all the constants with a single constant, or what I will do, I will replace now all the constants with a single constant. Now let us see now what we are going to get. So let now QE now divided by now 2m into V naught square will be numerically equal to K. Now that will be a constant. So what I am doing now, fairly simple. Now whatever the constants I am getting, or whatever the constants I am getting in the entire bracket, now that I am replacing with a single constant K. So therefore, now what you are going to get, so y will be numerically equal to kx square, or y will be numerically equal to kx square. And you are already familiar, now this equation will be representing a parabola, or this equation will be representing a parabola. So meaning what? So what is the conclusion we got? So the conclusion will be, now whenever the charged particle will be entering normal to the electric field, or whenever the charged particle will be entering perpendicular to the electric field, then remember the path that will be followed by the particle now inside the electric field will always be a parabola. So therefore, now remember, now whenever the charged particle will be entering normal to the electric field, or whenever the charged particle will be entering perpendicular to the electric field, then remember the path that will be followed by the particle now inside the electric field will always be a parabola. So remember, now this is representing a parabola. So now remember, this is representing a parabola, or this will be now representing a parabola. So therefore, the point to be remembered, now whenever the charged particle will be entering normal to the electric field, or whenever the charged particle will be entering perpendicular to the electric field, then remember the path that will be followed by the particle Now inside the electric field will always be a parabola. Remember it. Now that is the application we got. Now that will be the path that will be followed by the particle now inside the electric field. Now one more important thing. Now once you are familiar with this, or once you are familiar with this concept, so now can anybody not tell me now what will be the resultant velocity now as a function of time, or what will be the resultant velocity of the charged particle as a function of time? So can anybody now tell me now what will be the resultant velocity of the charged particle as a function of time now inside the electric field? So fairly simple. Now you already know. Now along the horizontal, the velocity will be Vx, and along the vertical, now let us say the velocity will be Vy. So you already know. The velocity will be remaining constant. So Vx will be numerically equal to V naught. And let us say now along the vertical, the velocity of the particle as a function of time will be Vy. So now we need to find now what will be the vertical velocity. And you already know the resultant velocity will be given by the diagonal of the parallelogram. So you already know if the horizontal velocity will be Vx and the vertical velocity will be Vy, then the resultant velocity of the particle will be given by the diagonal of the parallelogram not drawn from the same point. So now we already know the horizontal velocity that will be remaining constant, which will be equal to V naught. But what will be the vertical velocity of the particle as a function of time? So let us find out. So first I can write in the vector form. So V bar will be numerically equal to now Vx into I cap plus Vy into J cap. So therefore the modulus of the resultant velocity will be numerically equal to now under root of Vx square plus Vy square, or the magnitude of the resultant velocity will be under root of Vx square plus Vy square. So now we already know the value of Vx. So now we need to find now what is the vertical velocity now after a time t second. So how to find? Now very simple. Now how to find the vertical velocity? So if I take along the vertical, so you already know along the vertical the initial velocity will always be zero. So you already know along the vertical direction the initial velocity of the charged particle will be zero. Now similarly, the acceleration of the particle along the y axis will be qe divided by m. So now I want to find now what will be the vertical velocity now after a time t second, or what will be the vertical velocity of the particle as a function of time. So now what I need to do in order to obtain the vertical velocity, now apply the kinematical equation. Now apply the kinematical equation. So Vy will be numerically equal to Uy plus Ay T. So therefore, the vertical velocity will be numerically equal to 0. Now A we already know, that will be QE divided by M into T. Or remember, the vertical velocity will be numerically equal to now QEP divided by M. So remember, the vertical velocity of the charged particle after a time t second will be given by, so Vy will be numerically equal to now QED now divided by M. So now what I will do, I will substitute Vx and Vy in this equation. So now we can find out now what will be the resultant velocity of the particle. As a function of time inside the electric field. So if I remove all of them, now what I will do, I will substitute now both Vx and Vy. So therefore, now the resultant speed will be numerically equal to under root of now Vx will be numerically equal to V naught square plus Vy we already got, that will be equal to QET divided by M whole square, or we are going to get the resultant velocity will be numerically equal to now under root of V naught square plus Q square E square P square now divided by M square. So remember, now this will be the magnitude of the resultant velocity, or this will be the speed of the charged particle now inside the electric field as a function of time. So why? Because the charged particle will be moving simultaneously now along the horizontal now as well along the vertical. That's the reason why the charged particle will be having two dimensional motion. So that is the reason why the resultant velocity of the charged particle now inside the electric field will be given by the formula. So under root of V naught square plus Q square E square T square now divided by M square. So hope you understood this application very very well, the fourth application we got. So remember, this will be coming under lecture 7. And all the people who are looking, now please respond, now give your comments, so that now whatever doubts are arising, we can clarify your doubts, respond.
give as many number of comments you want to give. Now whatever suggestions you want to give. Now we are here to explain all your doubts. Now whatever is roaming in your mind, that will be clarified very well. So you need to come out, respond, look out all the lectures, make the notes of them, and I request all of them. Now please go through all the notes and come out with the comments. Now that will be a motivational factor for all the lecturers who are teaching on the dais. It will be a kind of inspiration for all of us. Now please give us your precious comments. Now that will be boosting our what we call the motivational factor. So thank you very much.